Sports time now, and we head on over to the sports studio. Say good evening to Mark Seal. Mark, some cricket news first up.
Yes, very good evening. I can tell you that defending Caribbean Premier League champions Barbados Tridents have added Australian all-rounder Marcus Stoinis to their lineup for the 2020 season. Stoinis, a hard-hitting batsman and medium-pace bowler, has been a journeyman in professional T20 leagues, playing at home in Australia, Kent in England, Delhi Daredevils, Royal Challengers Bangalore and Kings 11 Punjab in the Indian Premier League, and now for the Tridents in the CPL. In batting in 114 career matches, he has an overall T20 average of 32.83 and a strike rate of 128.29. And in bowling, he has taken 32 wickets with an economy rate of 8.73. Meanwhile, it was officially reported today, but a couple of weeks ago we said that top Afghan and world spinner Rashid Khan was indeed signed by the Tridents. The Tridents have also acquired Bajan all-rounder Kyle Mayers from the St. Lucia Zooks, while other internationals signed are batsman Alex Hales and pacer Harry Gurney from England, wicketkeeper Ramamullah Gurbaz of Afghanistan, and all-rounder Shehan Jahangir of Pakistan. The 2020 tournament is scheduled to take place between August 18th and September 10th. In more cricket news, there was a full training session for the West Indies this morning as final preparations are in full swing ahead of Wednesday's opening test against England. The Windies relocated to Southampton over the weekend as the first match is set for the GS Bowl. Head coach Phil Simmons says he was pleased with the conditions as both the weather and the pitch aided for a good training session. With much concern being placed on the performance of the batsmen in the warm-up games, he has assured everyone that they are ready to do their job.
I think the key thing for us is that we play proper cricket in all three facets of the game. We keep talking, harping on the batting, we're talking about the bowling has been strong, but I think we must feel well and catch well also to give ourselves that chance. So I think our frame of mind is that we have to play well in all three facets of the game in order to beat England. I'm not concerned about the batting. I think that the batsmen have worked very hard on getting to where they are now, and all that it takes now is for them, their mindset to be right for the test match. You have to be careful how you use an advantage, because with Root not being there, you have some youngster who wants to make a name for himself, and sometimes that's even harder than the players who you know. So I just am very careful about saying that it's an advantage.
Now, the last time those two sides met, it was a case where the Windies had to play catch-up to snatch the series. Coach Simmons says this time around, the aim is to go hard from the outset. And with the strong bowling attack, inclusive of the young bright spark in Alzarri Joseph, the men in maroon will be taking no prisoners.
I think it's an exciting group of fast bowlers. And I will add that even the reserve group has been it's been an exciting 4 weeks for us here as coaches. I think Alzarri has a lot to do with the outcome of this test series, because I think we know that Kimar and Shannon and Jason are our top bowlers, but Alzarri has been bowling so well that I think that he will have a lot to do with the outcome of this series.
The series is important for both sides, as England, currently on 146 points, are aiming to overtake New Zealand on 180 to go into third position in the ICC World Test Championship points table. While for the Windies, well, they'll be hoping to garner their first set of points, having previously lost 2-love to table leaders, India. Now, when the Windies and England create history on Wednesday, becoming the first teams to play test cricket in a biosecure environment during a global pandemic, things will be very different. Here's a look at some of the do's and don'ts of test cricket in a COVID-19 world.
Test cricket is back on July 8 as England hosts the West Indies in Southampton. But with the COVID-19 pandemic still prevalent, there will be several new rules and playing conditions in place to reduce risk of the virus spreading between players, support staff and officials. Number 1. The use of saliva to shine the ball will be banned. The ICC has stipulated that only sweat can be used to shine the ball, as saliva could transmit the virus. Artificial substances will remain banned. Umpires will first give players unofficial warnings should they forget about the rule, but if a team continues to use saliva to shine the ball, they will be given up to two official warnings and then a 5-run penalty. Number 2. Each team will have 3 reviews per innings instead of 2. The reason for this is the series will be played using local umpires instead of neutral ones so as to reduce the amount of travel required to stage the series. To remove any perception of bias, the teams are being given an extra review. Number 3. Teams will be allowed special COVID-19 substitutes should any player develop symptoms of the disease during the game. The player will immediately leave the field to go get tested, and a like-for-like replacement can be approved by the match referee. Number 4. Social distancing norms will be maintained through the game. This means players will not have bodily contact while celebrating and will not come in contact with umpires to hand over caps, sunglasses or other items of clothing. Number 5. Players and umpires have been advised to regularly sanitize their hands through the game, especially after handling the ball, which is seen as a possible carrier of the virus. It is also recommended that the umpires wear gloves while handling the ball. So cricket will not look quite the same when it returns amid the pandemic, but with 3.5 months having passed since the last international, there will no doubt be relief and excitement to hear the sound of bat hitting a saliva-less ball.